Get exercise, get plenty of sleep, wonderful goals to improve your health. But you might want to add forgiveness to the list. Joining us now is UAB psychologist Dr. Josh Klapow. All right, so give me the sell here. Okay. Forgiveness makes us healthier?
People who are able to forgive tend to have a better outlook on life. They're less likely to get angry. They're less likely to be stressed. And they tend to be, on average, in better health, physical health.
Well, that makes sense. I mean, stress, bitterness, it just eats you up.
It is. And let me say this. When I say forgive, I am not talking about forgetting. I'm also not talking about having painful memories just disappear. But I am talking about, as you said, getting rid of those kind of toxic emotions. Mm-hmm. And there's a system for doing that.
Okay. And you're not talking about just being a doormat.
No, not at all.
You got five steps. Yes. Walk me through the five steps.
There's a gentleman named Everett Worthington who developed this, and he uses an acronym called REACH. And so we'll walk through those quickly. Okay. R stands for recalling the events in an objective way. So you think about the thing that hurt you. Now, this is not easy.
But
you think about the event that hurt you, and what you're going to do is kind of remove your emotions. So what I mean is, you may say, they fired me. They stole from me. He left me. He hit me. She hit me. So you're talking about the actions, not the emotions. It's not easy, but that's where you want to concentrate to start off with.
Okay.
Pair it with the next, which is E. Now, this gets even harder, is empathize. So we're going to try to think about it from the other person's perspective. We're not forgiving them. We're not condoning it. But usually people hurt us when they're angry, when they're frustrated, when they feel shamed, intimidated, or scared. And sort of thinking about that that may be the reason is going to help us.
Okay. All right. That's two.
That's two. We go to A, which is an altruistic gift of forgiveness. And all that means is you're going to forgive and you're not expecting anything back. You're not expecting them to change. You're not expecting an apology. Okay?
Okay.
C, commit publicly to forgiveness. It's one thing to think about forgiving. It's another thing to write a letter to the person, to email them, to call them. It just makes it more intense and it makes it more potent. Final thing, H, is to hold on to forgiveness. You're going to naturally want to drift back. Mm-hmm. You're going to use the holding on to go through these steps to keep you in that place. And in the end, you know what this does? All those emotions that we tend to kind of ruminate on and eat us up inside, which causes bad health, that keeps those at bay, and it allows us to live a healthier life. Not forget about it, but not be consumed by those emotions.
Okay, quickly, REACH stands for R.
Recall the events objectively.
All right.
E, empathize. A, altruistic gift of forgiveness. C, commit publicly to forgiveness. And H, hold on to that forgiveness no matter how hard it is.
All right, I think you have reached us. Thank you.
Thank you.
Doc, we sure appreciate you being here.